A lot of you are really excited to hear about what's happening with the new Renault Zoe, the 2019/2020 model. Obviously, we're not going to look like this. It's going to be a facelift. There's going to be some more information, but I have had leaked information from a credible, trusted source about what this new version of the new Renault Zoe 2019/2020 is going to have on. So if you're thinking of ordering a VW ID or any of the other new electric cars out this year, you might want to stay tuned for this week's video first.
Are you listening? Damn.
Now, before I get into the main part of the video, it's very worth noting that this is a purely speculative video on my part. I've just rounded up all the rumours and all the leaks around the internet on what I think the new Zoe's going to have, and I've made a very, very clever, educated guess on what I think it's going to have on. Now, if you're thinking of buying a ZE40 at the moment, personally, I'd go and buy one. I think they're a great little car, and the equity that you'd still have in the car, even when the ZE50 comes out, which is rumoured to be at the start of next year, so you've got months and months and months that you could be driving a ZE40 in that meantime. And at the moment, ZE40's second-hand prices are really high. In fact, I've seen dealers sell ZE40s higher than what I can go and buy a new one for from dealers at the moment. So that is how strong the residual values are on the ZE40s at the moment. And that will never change. When the ZE40 came out, the 22 kilowatt car pretty much carried on going up in price rather than down. So if you are thinking about buying a ZE40, go ahead and buy one. I'd definitely buy one. I bought some in stock, like this one I'm sat in today. So yeah, don't let that put you off. It definitely won't put me off. It's also very worth noting that I have asked Renault for comment. They will not comment on any further speculations, which is why I put that little disclaimer at the start of the video. But this is what my guess is, and kind of a bit of a wish list of what I think the new Renault Zoe will have on. Now, I did a video 8 months ago that I thought the Zoe was going to have CCS and a 50 kilowatt battery. That still remains. I still think it's going to have CCS and a 50 kilowatt battery. I don't think the charge speeds are going to be as high as I said in that video, but I reckon it's going to be a ZE50 battery. So instead of ZE40, it's going to be a ZE50, 50 kilowatt capacity of the battery. I reckon it'll be exactly the same dimensions as the current battery. And that's because it's made on the same production line as the Renault Clio, which is where a lot of the guesses on this future video have come from. But yeah, I reckon it's going to be same dimensions. What I can tell you now, that I do not think that the battery will be backwards compatible with a ZE40 or a 22 kilowatt, and this is because I just think it's going to have different types of cooling system on it, so it will not be backwards compatible. So if you've got a 22 or a 40, you won't be able to then fit this 50 battery like you did previously on the other sort of 22. You could jump to a 40. It would obviously all fit and plug in play, so to speak. Now, one further thing I do need to ask you: can you please go and click subscribe down below? Give the video a thumbs up if you've enjoyed it. This is really important, as it helps the channel grow and it makes me make more videos. I make videos every single week about electric cars, mainly the Renault Zoe, so which is why I've got leaked information like this, where I'm willing to speculate on stuff. I also do videos on the BMW i3, so if you're interested in that sort of thing, click the subscribe button. If you click the notification bell, every time I make a new video, you'll get a notification in your inbox if you don't want to miss any. It's going to have more brake horsepower, 135 to be precise, and that'll mean rear discs. Now, obviously, as we all know, this is going to look pretty much completely different. I can't show you the photos that they've sent me, because that is the one thing that this source did not want unveiling, because it would give away when they saw the car, their connection to it, etc. So unfortunately, I can't show you the pictures, but think of the look at the new Renault Clio, the new Renault Modus, kind of like that. There's some spy pictures I've got of it covered up, which I can unveil, which I'll neatly display on the screen now. But yeah, unfortunately, I can't show the ones that they sent, but it does look good. The couple of things that I can tell you that they have changed on the front: we got rid of these lights that everyone complains about on the Zoe. It's now got LED lights. Oh, and it's also got LED fog lights. That's new. Okay, the one you all want to know about: charging plug. Now, as we already know, because it's been unveiled loads of times by Renault, they are keeping 22 kilowatt AC. All Zoes are going to have 22 kilowatt AC. Now, in my prediction video, I said that they're going to have CCS, which is, yes, they are. And I also said it's going to be an option. Yes, it is. Whether it will be an option in the UK or whether the Renault staff will spec it up with that standard, I don't know yet. But in most countries, it's going to be an option. Also, the battery could be software locked depending on which region you're in, but the majority of European users, including the UK, will be just the full 50 kilowatt. But regarding the CCS speed, I guessed 100 kilowatt, but unfortunately that 50 kilowatt battery, it can't handle 100 kilowatt, sadly. It will handle though 50 kilowatt DC, but it will now have a CCS combo plug under this little hatch here. This is where the big changes are coming in this car. Interior, completely different. Nothing like you see here. All this is being changed, the whole thing. If you want to know what it looks like, I'm going to display a little video on the screen to show you the new Clio, because it's pretty much the same. Apart from this bit here, before we get into the Clio video, this cluster here is going to be changed on the Zoe, and also it's going to be different to the Clio. It's going to have a 10-inch, I don't know if it's touchscreen, but I know it's a big screen, a big sort of TFT screen here. So that's going to have a big screen there. It's also going to have a big screen here. This is going to be a 9.3-inch multimedia screen, and the multimedia screen is going to have, drum roll please, over-the-air updates, which means it's more than likely going to be 3G or 4G compatible. I don't know the full specs, but I'm going to presume 4G to send all the data to the screen to update over the air. Whether it's over-the-air updates for car software as well, I don't know. I have a feeling that Renault will want to keep the dealer network happy, and some will be able to do over the air, but some will have to still go into a dealer. And also there'll be a safety side on there. Unlike Tesla, major manufacturers do not want to leave security holes where the car could be hacked, which is why they tend to lock down over the air stuff to basic things. So I don't know 100%, but assume over the air is only for multimedia stuff. We do expect though that the TomTom screen is going to have the new TomTom system, which is like Google Earth Maps, so 3D buildings, 3D imagery on there. However, also not fully confirmed by my source, but they've hinted that it's going to be a new version of R-Link. It is going to have Android Auto and Apple CarPlay. One of the other major improvements on the interior, there's going to be an induction charging system inside the car for phones, so you'll be able to charge your iPhone, your Samsung phones, anything with induction charging. There'll be an induction charger inside the front, and two USB sockets for the rear passengers. And I'm sorry, boy racers, the electronic handbrake I featured in that spy video a while ago, yeah, it's going to have an electronic handbrake, which for me is great news. It's also going to have some other driver's features. One of them is side collision warning. Bit like the Kona, it's going to have a little indicator on both your mirrors to let you know if there's someone in your blind spot, and basically flash. So more safety driving features. Along with these safety driving features, there's going to be lane assist. There's also going to be automatic braking at the front using a radar system. It's also going to read road signs, very similar to some other cars in the market at the moment. So it'll have road sign detection, so it'll be able to read speed limits, stop signs. And judging by all these little bits, I think it's going to have some form of lane keeping assist as well, which will physically move the steering wheel while you're driving on a motorway in roads like that. Whether it can react to those road signs, it wasn't clear in the information I was given. But I suppose if it's there, it could possibly do it in the future. Oh, as well as these rear sensors on the camera, by the way, you're also getting front sensors on the new Zoe, which will mean it is capable of self-parking. So I guess there's only one thing to say. If you've got any questions, comment down below. I'll try and answer any ones I can, and any ones I can reveal the information on. Thanks very much for watching this week's video. Don't forget to subscribe for more updates regarding the Renault Zoe and other electric cars, and check out my other videos. Thanks very much, and I'll see you again next week. Goodbye.